One of the problems is they forget who elected them. They forget who supported them, who encouraged people to vote for them. So we got to hold people accountable. They become these people, judges, elected officials become part of the status quo, thereby becoming part of the problem. Stand up. Don't give up the fight. Preacher man, don't tell me heaven is on the deer. I know you don't know what life is really worth. We need to build our own system. We need to build a system based on righteousness, a system based on some divine principles, a system based on equality and justice. They call it the justice system, but it's just us. We need justice, fairness, everybody.
If you call yourself a trigger, you will act like a trigger.
Criminals are organized. We are getting organized. So we thank God for the Detroit 300. Let's give God a hand clap.
Well, you know, it's been a long grind, and the city's had a lot of things go wrong, but I feel like things are going the right direction right now, and we're happy to be a part of it.
All right. Any other words you want to say?
Oh, glad you've been on our side.
Detroit for Detroiters first.
All right, welcome, welcome, welcome to the Get Up Stand Up Show. I am your hostess, Renee, stepping out on faith, and it is a pleasure. You hear me? A pleasure to be here with you this Tuesday evening. So what we're going to do is get you some information going on what's going on around, of course, our great city of Highland Park, because you know we're celebrating the centennial. That's right, 100 years on Highland Park, right here in the residence of Highland Park, and I'm very, very excited about that. Then we're going to have a special guest on the show, Miss Carol Banks of District 2, State Representative. We're going to let her experience work for us, right? So that's all right. So we're going to get on off into it because you know that hour, we're here from 6 to 7 and the hour does not wait on us. No, time doesn't wait on us at all. I'm going to give you guys an opportunity to call in. You know the number, 313-868-4336. You can ask questions when I get Ms. Banks on here. And I'm giving you an opportunity. I'm going to start right here with Facing Our Truth. The Theater and Dance at Wayne presents the Freedom Players performance of Facing Our Truth. 10 minutes play on Trayvon, race, and privilege. Inspired by the debates and nationwide protests following the acquittal of George Zimmerman in the killing of Trayvon Martin. This is written by A. Ray Pam and Matt, Dan O'Brien, Dominique Marisso, Mona Mansour, Winter Miller, Marcus Garley, Taylor Manassa. Charge it to my head, not my heart. I don't mean no harm. If I destroy your name, still love me, okay? Quetzal Flores. Now, this is a 10-minute plays, Talk Back with the Cast, Thursday, April 5th, 2018, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. General Motors Theater at the Wright. That's the Wright Museum. Charles Wright Museum at 315 East Warren Avenue, Detroit 48201. There's a phone number, 313-494-5800. The reason why I'm telling you about it is because I got tickets for you. I got three tickets. If you can give us a call and you're able, the caller that calls in are able to go to the Charles Wright with the guest pass and check out the 10-minute plays and the talk back with the cast. I think you're going to love it. And that phone number again is 313-868-4336. The African American Museum. I got these passes for you. So the caller that calls in, if you're interested in it, I have passes for you right here on the Get Up Stand Up Show. I want you to know that the Word of Truth Kajik, there's a prayer that's not nominated by our circumstances. There is a power that's not nominated. That's not intimidated by our circumstances. Don't worry, I got it. There is a power that's not intimidated by our circumstances. I can't stop repeating that. The Word of Truth, Church of God in Christ, worship with us every Sunday if you can. And that's at 7107 Rivard in Warren, Michigan, 48091. And of course, the phone number is 586-754-9673. And that's our very own Reverend Gardner. That's you catch a show every Tuesday morning at 7 a.m. from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. The Word of Truth Church. Oh, we got a call already. Let me get this together. I got a call. Call, you're on the air. Hello?
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I am thankful. And who am I speaking
with? I'm trying to win tickets.
Are you called to get these tickets, huh? I need to get a chance to get everything out good.
Yeah, I mean, do I have to answer a question? What do I have to do?
Not at all. You need to leave me, get to the front desk and leave your name and number, and I'll have two. Do you need two or one?
I actually need two.
All right.
One for me, one for my son.
I got them right here, putting them to the side. You see me?
Thank you.
What's your name? Thank Who am I speaking with?
Oh, well, Kim Smith is my name. Kim.
Kim Smith?
Yes, I've met you before. But
okay, that's a pleasure.
Okay.
I'm glad to hear it. I need you to dial 313-868-6612, Ms. Smith, and just to let them know so we can put your name at the front desk and have you pick up these tickets because they're here. Guest passes.
Okay, and I'm sorry. Let me get that number again. I didn't have a pen.
That's
ready.
Okay. Take your time. We're here.
And what is the number, please?
313-868-6612. And let them know you won the tickets from Renee Stepping Out on Faith on the Get Up Stand Up Show.
Okay. Thank you, Renee. I appreciate it.
It is my pleasure. Call me back after you go to it and let me know how you enjoyed it.
Okay, I'll do that. Thank
I hope
you.
So. All right. It's a pleasure. Thanks, Kim Smith. Love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Oh, that was really great. So I have one pass left. We had two gone already and one pass left. Let me see. Is this caller, you're on the air? Okay. So that was, they're gone.
Hello?
Oh, hello. You there?
Yeah. This is what I'm calling about. I watched the Barry Keller Lawyer Show, Law Power Hour Saturday.
Yes.
And there was a lady on there talking about the event happened April the 12th at the church on West Grand Boulevard, and I didn't know the name of the church.
Okay, what I need you to do is contact the main desk, the front desk, because unfortunately I'm not familiar, and
okay,
I don't want to give you any wrong information, okay?
What's that main number?
What's your name?
My name's Reginald Weatherly.
All right, Mr. Weathers, the phone number is 313-868-6612.
Wait,
868-6612.
6612.
Yep, and just let them know that information, and we'll do some research for you and find out what's going on.
I watched that you all are on my station, and that Law Power Hour, they had a program coming up April the 12th, and I wanted to find the name of that church. Thank you. I'm going to call the front.
All right, Mr. Weathers, thanks for calling. You have a blessed day, okay?
Hey, you too. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, you guys, I do have to get the announcements out. So remember that the city of Highland Park, Michigan, is celebrating 100 years this year. It is exciting. Who celebrates 100 years? Highland Park, Michigan. That's who does it, right? Highland Park officially became a city on April 4th, 1918. And this is year 2018 marks 100 years. And we are here to see it. We're living to see it. Do you hear me? There will be events to celebrate the centennial all year. Come on now. Here are the scheduled events for April. April 4th, that's tomorrow, 11 a.m., a banner dedication and opening celebration will be held at the Avalon Village. You know where that's at in Highland Park, located on Avalon Street between Woodward and 2nd Avenue. 6 p.m. birthday celebration at the Elks Lounge. And that's located at 50 Manchester in Highland Park, the famous Elks Lounge in Highland Park. April 8th, the 4 p.m., At 4 p.m., the Centennial Gospel Celebration at the New Grace Church at 25 Ford in Highland Park. April 8th, 4 p.m., Centennial Gospel Celebration at the New Grace Church, 25 Ford in Highland Park. Now, this is a big deal to me. All of it, all the events are a big deal. April 21st, 11 a.m., is a citywide health fair. I'm going to repeat that. April 21st. 11 a.m. is a citywide health fair at the Ernest T. Ford Rec Center, 10 Pickin. The famous Ernest T. Ford Rec Center, 10 Pickin. I love Highland Park, so yes, I will use the words like famous and the legendary and things of that nature because that's what Highland Park is to me, and it's 100 years, so the proof is in the pudding. So remember that the church, the Word of Truth Church of God in Christ Come and grow with us. Opportunities for worship, study, and fellowship. Sunday, intercessory prayer, 8:30 a.m. Sunday early worship, 9 a.m. Sunday school, 9:30 a.m. And main worship at 10:45 a.m. Remember, Wednesday Bible study classes for all ages starts at 7 p.m. And the third Friday, anointing and deliverance service at 7 p.m. If you want to check out the website, twtchurchministries.com. twtchurchandministries.com. twtchurchandministries.com. And that's Pastor Robert and Melestine Gardner. It's great. It's great. And I just one last thing before we go. We still have this last pass for the Charles Wright Museum. I want you guys to know, I read from the Highland Park Journal, the Metro Business Information Guide. If you actually, I know you've seen it. I know you've seen it all over the city of Highland Park and some areas in Detroit. But there are so many things in this paper, so many articles. Aaron's Jewelry and Loan. Room for rent on the second floor in Highland Park included full kitchen, bedrooms, living room, dining room, drug-free environment, and drug-free environment. 313-645-2282. So expert plumber, all type of ads and information, health-wise. Our very own Health-Wise Enterprises inside this Highland Park Journal. And this is brought to us by Mr. Chris Woodard. I did want to let you guys know before we move on to Miss Banks, because she's coming up next, that WHPR TV 33 owner RJ Watkins and is flanked by HP City Clerk Honorable Brenda Green and City Administrator Kathy Squares. There's an ad in the paper. There's an article in the paper about that. You may even see Renee Stepping Out on Faith article in the paper. So let me know if you got a chance to take a look at it and check it out. There's writers and associates wanted. Transportation drivers needed, part-time people's community service in Hamtramck. Must have experience driving seniors. Must have CDL with passenger endorsement. If interested, call Grace Holness at 313-365-6260. All right, those were the announcements. Hopefully everybody got a chance to get a hold to it. I need to bring Miss Carol Banks on. We're going to go to commercial break, and we will be right back. Don't you touch that dial. It's hot.
One of the problems is they forget who elected them. They forget who supported them, who encouraged people to vote for them. So we got to hold people accountable. They become these people, judges, elected officials become part of the status quo, thereby becoming part of the problem.
Stand up. Don't give up the fight. Reach a man, don't tell me.
All right, I am Renee Stepping Out on Faith, and welcome back to the Get Up Stand Up Show, normally with Malik Shabazz, Minister, Brother Minister Malik Shabazz. Today I have Chief of Staff of Councilman Scott Benson, Miss Carol Banks of District 2. I would look, normally we have applause, you know. It's good to have you in the building. How are you?
I am awesome. Glad to be here.
Awesome works.
Yes.
And glad to be here. We're glad to have you here.
Okay.
You look really good on your flyers. Vote for Carol Banks, right?
That's right. Running in State Rep District 2 on the east side and in Three Gross Points.
Okay, so that is the east. District 2 is more so the east side of Detroit?
East side of and Detroit Gross Point. And Three Gross Points, Gross Point Park, Gross Point City, and Gross Point Farms. 11% of the district is in Gross Point, and 89% of it is in Detroit.
Okay. Well, you know what? I got some questions for you here.
Okay.
And then I see that this letter here that says, Dear Neighbor, that makes me believe that you wrote this letter to the residents?
Yep. I wrote it to the residents of District 2, introducing myself, letting them know who I am, where I've been, where I'm going, and giving them my track record, showing them that I'm not somebody who just dumped into the district, but I've lived there all my life. born and raised.
I was going to ask you, did you go to school in Detroit?
That's right. Born and raised in Detroit. Went to Lily Bridge. Went to Whitney Young, which when it was on Field and Agnes. Mm-hmm. Of course, you know, Lily Bridge is now vacant land.
Oh, like Highland Park. Huh?
But it's okay. It's okay. It's mm-hmm. all right. Graduated from Denby High School. Went to the University of Houston. Went to Texas Southern for a few minutes.
Okay.
Came back. Went to the College of Lifelong Living at Wayne State. Got a couple of certifications. Well, business administration, yeah. computer science.
All the right ones.
Yeah, all from the College of Lifelong Living in 1989.
Okay.
So, and I've been in Detroit all of my life, except for the couple of years that I left and went to Texas Southern. But I'm homegrown. I know the East Side, and I love the East Side.
She said she's homegrown.
That's right.
I love that. I can feel it all right here. It's up in the air.
I'm excited. So
hey. I'm excited too. I'm just grazing through the letter
right
here. I wish I'd have got one.
Oh,
but
that's
I'm
okay.
a resident of Highland Park.
Oh no, I sent it to
okay.
Detroiters and Grosse Pointers.
Yeah, I got some people that's ready to go to Grosse Pointers looking in there.
Okay.
But I noticed here that you are a former school board member.
Yes. I was elected by the citizens of Detroit by 36,000 votes.
Mm.
I was a school
Say
board.
That again, Ms. Banks.
36,000 votes.
Okay.
I was number 4 at when it came to being at large. I served from 2009 to 2013.
Okay.
And there I did a host of things. I served on the Public Health and Safety Committee there.
Mm-hmm.
I served on the Audit Committee there. I served on the Parent Committee there.
Oh, right.
And I was really real successful in working with Safeway Transportation.
Okay.
When her contract, she had some issues with it, and they were going to terminate it. And the school board was real effective in making sure that contract was not terminated.
All right.
We saved about 90 jobs, and they were all Detroiters.
That's what we're talking about.
So I'm just saying I have a track record. I've mm-hmm. been around, and I've done some things that help citizens in Detroit.
So people can check your record.
That's right. You can check my record, and it's valid.
I like this. I'm active in many community groups and organizations in the district. I mm-hmm. have worked on various projects from hosting violence prevention workshops to working with seniors on issues to help preserve their quality of life.
Mm-hmm.
I am a founder and creator of Grandparents Raising Grandchildren program at the Neighborhood Service Organization, formerly known as the NSO.
Right.
I You're like right. that.
Yep. Me along with Jerutha Kennedy,
mm-hmm.
Robert Shimkowski, and Beverly Limley, we were just brainstorming one evening.
Okay.
And before we knew it, we said, let's write this grant. And we wrote the grant to, what is it called, United Way.
Oh, yes.
And we were funded for the first 5 years, about $3 million.
Hello.
Yes, we were funded. And the program went on from about 1999. And just recently, I would say in 2010, they lost their funding.
Really?
Yeah, so they're no longer in existence. But still, I work with grandparents.
That's right.
I am a grandparent myself. I have 3 grandchildren.
Mm-hmm.
I have one child who is autistic.
Okay.
And I've been raising him since birth. But I work with grandparents now. They call me just at will, and I try to do as much as I can. I'm also involved in the RAMP program.
Okay, and tell me something about the
RAMP
program.
The RAMP program is something that we started in District 3 with Councilman Scott Benson.
Okay.
We had a mother call us and say that her mother could not get out of her house. She had been homebound for about a year.
Okay.
And the reason why she couldn't get out is because she couldn't get down the steps.
Okay.
So the daughter was carrying the mother on her back,
I don't know.
Getting her in and out of the house. And then one day she slipped and fell.
Oh.
Right.
No.
So they could not get.
Nobody couldn't get out.
Right.
Or
so
in.
She called us, and it took us about 6 months.
Okay.
To a year to find somebody to come and build the ramp. So we contacted some contractors who built a ramp on their house for free, no charge.
Right.
And now we have 14 more ramps that we're going to build on the east side of Detroit for those people who are homebound, and they just have to call our office. We do an intake to make sure it's no funny-duddy stuff going
right.
on.
Right, make sure it's for real.
For real, and we'll go out and handle our business.
And what's the office number?
313-224-1198.
One more time, Ms. Banks.
313 224-1198. And that's if you're interested and you have a senior that's homebound who needs a ramp, we'll work with it. We're doing right now District 3 and District 4 on the city of, in the city of Detroit.
Now, is District 3 Eastside also?
Yes.
Forgive my ignorance.
District 3 is Eastside. District 4 is Eastside. Okay. But if there's a Westsider that is in need, we won't turn them down
that's
as long
what
as
I'm
they
talking
qualify.
About. One more time with that.
If there is a Westsider that is in need, we don't turn them down. As long as they qualify.
Nobody left behind.
No, nobody left behind.
All right. So let's get to those was my Q&A.
Okay.
Now we're going to get to what's written.
Okay. All right.
So as the chief of staff to Councilman Scott Benson, what are your responsibilities?
Well, my daily responsibilities are an array of things. I deal with making sure that the budget is correct for our office.
Yes, ma'am.
I deal with the staffers. We have five staffers that are on our staff, six including me. I make sure that they're on point, on task, and on time. I deal with the policy. The legislative piece, there are different city ordinances that we work with, and I have to make sure that my policy staff researches it and gets it right so that we can present it and it becomes an ordinance. I also deal with any special activities that we have. We do the marshmallow drop.
Okay.
The movie night out with our seniors.
Oh.
Yep. We had a great time with that. Hats, gloves, and scarves. We give hats, gloves, and scarves right now to two schools.
Okay.
And coats. A.L. Holmes and Davison. Eastside again.
Okay.
And then our big special project that we have, I've already discussed that with you, is the ramp program.
Right. Okay.
And then we do a little fun. We call it Bingo with Benson.
Okay.
We do that in December, and I make sure that all the sponsors and donors are on point, on task, and making sure that that's a fun-filled day and not charging anybody a dime.
Really?
Yeah, and they get great prizes.
Make sure you keep me posted on that type of stuff. I'm going to do some bingo with Benson.
So those are some of the things we do. And then, of course, you know, I make sure that somebody's at all the community meetings for the district. I make sure that the office is staffed on the east side, our district office, from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. daily.
What location is that?
That's at the Matrix Center.
Okay.
13560 East McNichols.
That's what I'm saying.
Yes. Every east side.
East side. All that. You know, we shout that. Represent our area all the time, our location. As a former Detroit Public School board member, what were your duties?
Well, of course, I told you the three committees I sat on.
Yes,
which
ma'am.
Is public health and safety, audit, and parenting. Mainly our duties was to make sure that there was the proper legislation for parents and children to have safe schools. But during the time that I was a school board member was the time that we were under emergency management.
Okay.
So it was very difficult for us to do and perform our duties. One piece of legislation that I did do and work on was the bullying piece.
Good.
That became a piece of legislation for Detroit Public Schools. We did send it to Lance, and it did come back, and it was approved. And that was the first big piece of legislation I did as a school board.
I like to hear words like it was approved.
Yeah,
good job.
By the governor, by the emergency manager. Yeah, at that time we had somebody, you know, who was on our neck, had their hands on our neck, so it was very hard for us to do a whole lot.
But you still were. Approved.
Oh yeah, we were effective.
We still were effective.
We were effective, and I did a lot of things because my grandson is autistic. I worked with the special needs community. In DPS, they hadn't had a representative for a while, so we did some things in Lansing with the special needs department in terms of funding and resources, and we kind of helped parents get through the red tape of getting disability for their children. So that wasn't something that was mandated as a school board member, but because my passion was for disabled children.
That's right.
Because nobody fights for them. I was really effective in getting some resources for the parents.
I'm sure you were.
Yeah.
I'm sure. And I love it. And I'm sure you continue.
Oh yeah. Just help Miss Verna Brock out. We got to give a shout out to Verna Brock because she's still on the battlefield.
Right.
She had a parent who called her and the lights and gas were cut off, and they had two disabled children who had machines that need you know, to go.
And, you know, they're not supposed to do that.
They're not.
You're supposed, if they take the, to my understanding, if they take the medical information
right.
to the, or fax it or whatever to the light and gas mm-hmm. company, they'll leave your service.
Well, somehow that fell through the cracks.
Mm.
But she contacted my office, and we were able to successfully get that turned back on.
So, I love that.
I mean.
I love it. I love hey. It. That's a good thing.
Yes, yes, yes. So always on the battlefield, always.
Tell me, who is Carol Banks?
Who is Carol Banks? Carol Banks is somebody, no matter what you need or what you want, I try to be a servant for the people. And for me, it's really not a job.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like, you know how when you're a staffer and you watch people and you watch people go through the motions, and you just say, there's got to be a way that I can help not just my staff, but help the community.
All right.
And at one point, I was just a community activist. Okay. I started this. Actually, I joined the Shrine of Black Madonna when I was 13 years old.
Did you? How'd you know that that's what you needed to do?
I didn't.
At 13?
I didn't. I didn't. My brother-in-law took me to the shrine,
mm-hmm.
and I just fell in love with it.
It was there.
Yeah, it was there, chemistry. And I just felt good about what they were saying and what they were doing at 13, and then I knew my purpose was to be a servant.
Amen.
And I didn't mean to be a servant with a title. I meant to just be a servant where I could help people. And I was at 13,
mm-hmm.
and my mother used to fuss, girl, you can't, you only 13, you can't save the world.
She didn't know.
Right.
I don't know why she didn't know that she, you her baby.
And I just kept on and kept on. Before, I was just doing little things, getting teenagers together, cleaning up the neighborhood.
You know, that's a sign of leadership.
Well, hey, I just wanted to do something. And then before I knew it, it just grew into me just doing things all the time, regardless of where I was or who I connected with. I just wanted to help people.
I love
and
that.
And I've just been doing it
since. And you haven't stopped?
No.
It's because it's in
stopping.
You.
Don't, it, and for me, it's not about a title.
Mm-hmm.
It's about you as an individual filling out what your purpose is, what God placed you on earth to be.
I agree. Say that again for me, Ms. Banks.
I said it's your purpose, and it's what God placed you on the earth to be or
Amen.
To do. So for me, it's more just let's just get it done. Don't complain. I mean, because we got a whole lot of stuff we can complain
oh,
about.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, I got a lot of stuff I can complain about.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, I'm more solution-driven.
I love that. I believe we got a couple calls, and then I'll go back to questions and answers. Caller, you're hot on line one on the Get Up Stand Up show. Hello?
Good evening.
Greetings and good evening. How are you?
I am fine. Are you speaking to me, Renee?
I am. Do I need, what's your name? I can address you.
This is Sister Keela.
Hey, Sister Keela.
No,
how are you today?
I am blessed. Did you have any questions for Ms. Carol Banks?
Well, I have a few comments. First of all, I want to give a shout out to Carol Banks. Oh. We did serve together on the Detroit Board of Education.
Mm-hmm.
And during my tenure there with Carol Banks, we were under emergency management.
Okay.
But one of the good qualities about Ms. Banks is that she did not stop fighting for the children.
That's right.
When we were on the school board, we definitely understand what it is to have our power stripped from us. Mm-hmm. We understand what it is to have our representation stripped from us. And when you have that understanding and you continue to work in the interest of the children, then that's a true fighter. I've known Ms. Banks to be in the community for a very long time, not only as it relates to politics, but as it relates to Operation Get Down over on the Lower East Side of Detroit, Alkiva Land, which is located over there off of Van Dyke. Carol Banks has been very instrumental in the community. She's not a Johnny come lately type person. So I know with someone such as Carol Banks in Lansing, who understands policy and who understands, more importantly, who she works for. So often we elect people to political positions, and once they get in those positions, they forget that we are their boss.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Carol definitely, when she was on the school board, demonstrated that she understood who she represented, and she represented the children well. So So based on Carol Banks' track record with the Detroit Board of Education, with her community involvement, and her personal experience, I am sure that she will make a very good state representative, and I encourage everyone who lives in her district to vote for Carol Banks.
Wow. All right. Well, thank you, Sister Akilah.
Thank you, Sister Akilah.
And we have another call. I want to take this call.
God bless.
God bless. We love you. All right, caller, you're hot on the Get Up, Stand Up, and our special guest is Carol Banks of District 2.
Praise the Lord. Hello.
Praise the Lord. How are you?
What is your name, by the way?
I'm Renee, stepping out on faith.
Okay, thank you, Renee.
And what's your name?
Thank you for taking my call.
And what's your name?
I'm Rosa Watson.
Rosa Watkins, you don't know who I am. What you mean?
No.
I'm kidding. But you're supposed to know. We talk all the time, but that's okay. Did you have any questions for Carol Banks?
No, my husband said you look like someone else.
That's these glasses. That's because I need to see.
Dealing with the Black Music Awards, so I wanted to make sure.
That's okay. It's me.
Okay.
It's me.
Yes, I know. I talked to you, but I didn't really remember your name.
Okay.
But I'm calling about Miss Banks.
That's right.
She's a wonderful worker, an excellent worker.
All right.
She's been an excellent worker for years, working with Alberta Tenzi Talabi. We used to deal with the senior citizens at Cobo Hall.
Oh, that's right.
Because Gladys Hazel used to get a limousine take a lot of us from Bart McFarlane there to help the senior citizens fill out the forms.
All right.
And she has been a worker. She would even bring her son. I remember her son when he was young on a Saturday.
That's
I mean, she is a hard worker.
My son is 24 now.
When you call, she answers. And I appreciate her, and I want to tell her openly and publicly that she has been a hard worker, and she deserves everything, including Sister Malika Bar's wife. Mm-hmm. You know, she was on the board of education. They both did a wonderful job. I just love them both. I mean, so I just had to call in.
Well, we just love you.
Calling. Thank you for taking my call.
Always.
Thank you. Work.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for the compliment.
We appreciate you. Have the phones lit up, Sister.
Uh-uh.
Sister Banks, you are hot on the Get Up Stand Up show. I'm Renee, stepping out on faith. We have Sister Carol Banks of District 2, Democrat for State Representative in the building. Who are we speaking with?
Yes, good evening.
Good evening.
I just wanted to know, who is your guest, and could you tell us what office she's running from and what district? I'm going to hang up so that I can listen up there.
Okay, my name is Carol Banks. I'm running for state representative in District 2, which is on the east side of Detroit. It's 89% Detroit, 3 Grosse Pointes, Grosse Pointe Park, Grosse Pointe City, Grosse Pointe Farm. The district starts at Burns and Jefferson, picks up Jefferson Chalmer, picks up the river, goes all the way back to Connor Creek, picks up the 3 points, comes all the way back around to I-94 and Connor, and a little piece of Gratiot and Van Dyke.
All right, well, yeah, and that's a repeat, and that's fine. It's District 2.
It's District 2.
That's right.
That's State Representative District 2 on the east side of Detroit.
I'm going to get some more. I'm going to take this call and I'll get some more Q&As, because if you notice, the time flies.
Yeah, it's going by fast.
Caller, you're hot on the Get Up Stand Up show. I'm Renee, stepping out on faith, and I have vote for Carol Banks, District 2, State Representative. Who are we speaking with?
Avery.
Avery. Hello, Avery. How are you?
Good.
It's good to hear from you. Are you watching the show?
I get on there right now.
We're glad you called us. I'm doing fine. We have Carol Banks of District 2 in the building with us today, and we're going to continue.
Hi,
Carol.
Hi, how you doing, Avery? I hope everything's going good with you. Hi, Avery.
Thank you.
Thank you for calling.
All right,
we love you.
All right, bye-bye, Avery. Have a great evening.
I did want to... I had some more...
Go ahead, ask your questions.
I am. I wanted you to... Okay, I want to ask questions, and I want to talk about this here so everybody will know
cool.
where to go and what to do, right?
Okay, no problem.
Okay, so let's... Before I can even ask you, what have you been involved in? The callers or the viewers are calling in and telling us what you've been in your history.
Right.
And that's a blessing for people to stick up for you and stand up for you. You know what? To me.
It is. And I'm going to tell you, I've been doing this so long, there's so many things that I forgot some of those things that I've done. Because as you do things, you know, you do it so quickly. And for me, it's not. It's just...
I thought twice.
Yeah, I don't think about it. I just jump out and do it and then start on another project. So
I love that.
If I sit down and think about it, I do have a big track record. And I'm not trying to brag or anything, but
toot the horn.
Again, I do it from my heart.
Please.
It's not for any rewards.
That's right. Let God be the glory.
And I've always done things
to God.
For not just... You, of course, for God.
Of course.
I put my life in three orders. God first, family second, and career third.
All right.
And that's how I've lived my life. And I'll
perfect
continue.
Order.
Yes, that's just how I do it.
I want to give a shout out to Sister Akilah for actually calling in and standing in for you, stepping up for you.
Yeah.
Because that props are due when they're due, mm-hmm. where they're due, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I know you.
I appreciate that.
You don't want to toot your horn,
no,
but
I don't like
people
to
will
do
it for you.
And that's good
when
thing.
You're doing a great job. So we're going to keep it moving because time is ticking.
Okay.
And I got about 12 minutes to get these questions off.
Go ahead.
Why should we support you for state rep?
One, you should support me for state rep because I am a part of Detroit and I stand for Detroit and I've been in Detroit. And for me, it's not about a title. It's about sending somebody to Lansing who's going to make sure the quality of life is good for the citizens of Detroit and Grosse Pointe. And at some point, we have to begin to bridge that gap between Detroit and Grosse Pointe because it's either us against them or them against us.
Okay.
And at this point, we need to bridge that gap.
That's
and
right.
I think that I'm the person. No, I feel I can bridge that gap.
That's right.
Because I'm just not going to be out there for me, but I'm going to be out there so that we can build a better quality of life for all of us, Detroit and Grosse Pointe.
Will you work to lower the insurance rates for Detroiters?
Oh, absolutely. I'm going to give you a short, quick story.
Yes,
I had
ma'am.
A car accident in August.
Oh.
Thank God that I'm still here. Bad accident. And my car insurance was $333
which
a month.
Which is high.
Which is high
mm-hmm.
for full coverage, which was a 2007 Jetta. Okay?
Okay.
Car got towed up, got totaled. All right. My insurance jumped, doubled that.
Oh,
and
my
it's
God.
Not even full coverage now. It's just limited liability. I bought a car from the auction.
Mm-hmm.
It's a 2005 Durango, and they want me to pay double that now.
$600-$700
for no fault. $698 for no fault, no liability, because the car doesn't have any value.
Right.
So it's no need to put full coverage on it, just
right.
so I can have liability to drive it. I work to see, I get upset every time I tell that story.
I believe that. I'm upset. I understand.
I get upset. But I will work to lower the insurance. And what brings our insurance up is the PIP, Personal Injury Protection.
Okay.
We're the only state in the country that has unlimited medical. So at some point, yes, we have unlimited medical.
Mm.
So we have to figure out, because those costs, when you go as an injured car person in an accident,
uh-huh.
those numbers are tripled at the hospital. If I go to the hospital and I broke my foot
mm-hmm.
and I get the same thing that the person who was in the car accident done, the person in the car accident is going to be tripled that amount.
What?
Yeah, so we have to work with the medical profession, the insurance companies, to try to drive those numbers down. That's what's really driving the cost of insurance up in the city of Detroit and in the state of Michigan. And the other piece, though, too, is because we live in Detroit,
mm-hmm.
we still have that redlining. Whereas our insurance, I have a friend that lives in, she lives in Harrison Township. She
mm-hmm.
works on my campaign. She said her insurance for the whole year is $1,000.
I believe it.
She got a pretty nice car.
I lived in Sterling Heights. I had full coverage on a 2012 2008, something like that, Impala, right? $180 plus renter's insurance. $180 was full coverage plus renter's insurance in Sterling Heights.
Right. So, yes, we have to work. As a legislator, we have to work to try to get that down,
right?
Especially in Detroit, because it's outrageous. We can't. You have to make a decision. Are you gonna drive a car eat, or you just gonna eat?
Did you say drive a car and eat?
Right.
Or just gonna eat?
Right.
I believe that.
I mean, yes, I will work to deal with that, and we've got to work with the Republicans really hard on that, and the governor.
Are they workable?
I'm going to say we have to work on it.
And we will. Carla, you are hot on the Get Up Stand Up show with Carol Banks for District 2's Democrat for State Representative.
Yes, real quick so that you can send the rest of your questions. Don't forget July the 1st is going up on the no-fault insurance, $29. Mm-hmm. Don't forget that. See, they passed that and just don't even let you know or vote on it or nothing. I'm going to hang up and let you respond on it. Thank you.
Say it's going up $29.
Yeah, the legislation, the legislators in Lansing just passed that no fault would go up by between $29 and $33.
Now, when you say the legislature, so we didn't get, like he said, we didn't get a chance to vote on it. No. It didn't come through the mail. We didn't get a letter. Nothing.
No, that was a bill that was presented in Lansing, and it was actually passed by the legislation. I'm going to post on my Facebook page and on my votecarolbanks.com the whole bill. And I'll put a summary on there to explain exactly what happened and how it happened, because we as citizens need to know. What should have happened is our legislators should have been telling us, hey, you need to be calling the Republicans. Hey, you need to be calling the Democrats so that we can ensure that this doesn't happen. But they kept it quiet, so of course it passed.
And that's legal?
Yes.
Okay, let's keep it moving. will you support black and women and small business to go into business?
Oh, absolutely. I am currently working with a group of young ladies, and I mean young ladies. They're between 18 and 24.
Mm-hmm. I remember those days.
Yeah. One has a little entrepreneur business called Knitted Creations.
Nice.
I have another young lady that I am working with, and she's in the home and healthcare business. And then I have one other young lady who's trying to put together something for summer youth in terms of recreation and working with them. So I definitely support them. I work with them to find any grants and things that we can do to help them to promote themselves. Plus, we need to work with DEGC and get on them to help.
What is DEGC?
That's Detroit Economic Growth, and that is a part of the city of Detroit where they're supposed to help small businesses and entrepreneurs to get on their feet and get their paperwork together and help them to find matching funds so that they can become a stronger business.
We only got about 5 minutes. Uh-oh. This I need you to do real quick, and I'm going to say what's going on Sunday, April 8th, real quick. Will you pledge right here and now to sponsor legislation reciting the racist anti-urban public act number 4, the Emergency Manager Act?
Oh, absolutely. I don't have a problem with pledging to that. That was a draconian piece of legislation that took away our rights as citizens. And as you know, people died for the right for us to have democracy. Mm-hmm. So I would definitely pledge, write about it, whatever it needs
Shout.
To take place. That's right. because that's a terrible law in the state of Michigan. And it's hurt people, and it's set back children in the city of Detroit 2 decades. We've had emergency managers since 1999, and now we're trying to rebuild the system, and we lost 2 generations of children.
Oh, my goodness, and that makes me feel. I'm a grandmother also.
Yes.
So, well, I want you to come back. I'm asking you to come back and
be with us anytime.
And sit in with us. We didn't get a chance to get through all the questions. Time doesn't wait for any of us. What I do want everybody to know that Carol Banks, a District 2 Democrat for state representative, invites you to the movies. A campaign kickoff fundraiser Sunday, April 8th, 2018. That's this year. That's right. The special screening of Tyler Perry's Tyler Perry, but we know who Taraji. Acrimony, starring Taraji P. Henson. 5 p.m. The doors are open. This is at the Bel Air Luxury Theater, 10100 East 8 Mile Road, Detroit, 48234. Tickets are $25. It includes drinks and popcorn. All donations are accepted. Checks payable to Friends of Carol Banks. RSVP, please call 313-244-5509. 200 people are permitted. And remember, www.votecarolbanks.com. right?
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
This is the Get Up Stand Up Show. I am Renee stepping out on faith. This is Vote for Carol Banks,
That's
District
right.
2
Carol
for Democrat
Banks.
State Representative.
Let my experience work for you.
All right. And we're out of here.